These are three quick tips that you could use when you're creating an animation on Canva. Stick with me until the third tip because the third one is the best. Tip number one, I find landscape video easiest canvas to create an animation. Say that because it already is on video, it has a playhead that you could manipulate scenes and stop and play and edit, etc. Over and above that, you could also add transitions that are matching your scenes. So you could really go really creative when you're creating an animation on your landscape video or any video for that matter. It does not mean that you can't use the animation on your social media posts, your PowerPoint presentations, etc. You can still use that for that. It's just that when you're really into creating animation, the video format is the best. Tip number two is about the video that we've created already. It's available on our channel. It is the basics of how we use AI to create an animation on Canva. And we've seen on that video that if we go to apps, then we go and we see and we find the text to image, we can create amazing, gorgeous, unique scenes that we can use with our animations. It does not mean that when you don't have the time to come up with clever prompts, there is no workaround. So tip number two is about that workaround. When you are on Canva, select elements and then search for different kinds of scenes. So say, for example, you're searching for a green scene, and then Canva will show you all different kinds of scenes that are available for you to use with paths and forest, etc. So say, for example, we're looking for a crime scene and we go graphic, then we find different all sorts of elements that could help you create a crime scene if you're creating that kind of an animation. This scene I found on the green scene, I just added a black rectangle as a tar road, and then my scene was ready in seconds. And that's my tip number two to help you create quicker animation on Canva. Now on to our last tip. Canva has elements that are static and elements that are animated. And to find them, you're going to type your search and then click on the nodes or the settings, scroll down and find static or animated. Select animated. So when you're creating an animation, it is just a given that you're going to be using elements that are animated. That's going to give your creative process a quicker and a very smooth and seamless kind of way when you're creating your animation. When we select the element and we are ready to animate, we will click on animate and then the element animation open up. You're going to click on create an animation so that you can drag your animation around. Let's quickly have a look at the tips. The tips say hold shift whilst dragging to create straight lines. This is a tip. It's not how you are supposed to use it, because generally, as you see the example that they're showing us there, if you just click the element and you start moving the element around, you can make it do whatever you want and move it exactly the way that you want. And that looks pretty cool. When you want to use the tip that they're saying to you, hold it and you hold the shift key or the arrow up key, then it gives you those boxy straight lines for your animation. So if you want a rounded animation look, then don't hold your shift key or your arrow up. So I would like to create him going absolutely bananas with his. You just carry on, click, hold, and then it creates those amazing, amazing looking animation. Then don't forget to make it smooth if you want it to run smoothly, or if you want to make it go steady, you can click on steady. Once you're happy, you click on done. Just for fun, we found a boy walking, reading, and it was an animated element. We added our animation and we were happy with the path. And if you don't like the path you saw at the bottom of the page, you can delete the path and add a new path, so you can just play around until you're comfortable and you're happy with your animation. This is how the end results looks like. Let me know in the comments below if you've enjoyed this video. If you've missed our first video, we're talking about AI please go watch that video now. Thank you so much for joining me. I will see you on the next video.